Everybody, I hope you're having a wonderful day. It's really sunny here, but very cold, so I'm all snuggled up inside. And today we are going to be doing round two with the Zulu palette by Juvia's Place. I had a lot of fun trying it out last time, and I've played around with it a bit by myself, so I know a bit more about how the shadows work. And I'm going to be doing much more of a warm toned look. As a reminder, this is what the palette looks like. As you can see, I've gone in to some of the shades. I've had a really good play, and I'm excited to show you a really nice eye look, fingers crossed anyway. To start, I'm going to go into this Magnifies Rimmel palette called London News is Calling, and I'm just going to go into that cream colour right at the top. And I'm going to take that on a contour brush and pack that onto the lid to set the concealer that I put down first. That just makes sure that the colours don't stick to odd parts of my eyes and that everything blends really seamlessly. As you can see, I've done my base makeup. I've really been enjoying the Ordinary foundation that I tried out the other day. I'm on the lookout at the moment for a really nice setting powder, because I'm finding that my foundation's moving a lot and sticking to kind of dry patches. Well, not really the foundation, but the powder that I'm using, because it is just a Primark powder. But that's another video, so let's get back into the one we're doing at the moment. I'm going to take the same brush that I just took the cream colour, and I'm going to go straight into that bright yellow shade there. I'm going to use the mirror in my heat palette so that I can see what I'm doing. And we're just going to tap into the yellow colour. Picks up really nicely on the brush, really pigmented, and I'm going to kind of place that all over the lid, or all over this part of the lid anyway, kind of as our transition colour. It's obviously not a transition colour because it's bright yellow, but it's sitting in the crease and onto the lid a bit, and then I'm going to blend it down a bit when we've put some more colours down. This is probably my least favourite shade that's in the palette. I think maybe because of the undertones, it's not quite as warm toned on the lid as it shows in the palette. It's still really lovely. By me saying that it's not my favourite shade does not mean that it's not an absolutely beautiful shade. It is absolutely lovely. I just think probably because of what I'm used to with blendability, I'm still probably slightly scared of applying colours like this to my lids, because if you don't blend them out perfectly, it's very, very obvious. I'm using quite a lot of product here, but that's okay. That's to be expected. Okay, I'm then going to flatten my brush and kind of take that underneath my eye, blending down. Yesterday, whenever I filmed this, I did kind of a fiery look. I'm trying to recreate that look today. Last time I did a video for you, I did kind of a peacock, bluey, greeny, shimmery eye. Today we're really trying to emulate fire and very warm toned, because this palette is quite split, because you have all the cool tones, and kind of the purple's quite cool as well, and then you have all these lovely warm tones. And I'm really excited to play with them all, and I've used them every day. This has been my palette of choice for the week. I'm now going to go into this brown shade right here, tap in with the same brush I'm just reusing because we're blending them all together, and by putting this brown onto the yellow, it kind of mutes it, which is something I've really been enjoying. And you can kind of blend it all the way into your crease, and that kind of acts as your transition colour. If you imagine the yellow is kind of a base colour, a bit like kind of setting your whole lid with like a matte paint pot or something. If you imagine that's what you're doing with the yellow, and then take the brown as a transition colour, and you kind of get this warm russet orange colour, which I've really been enjoying. It's very unseasonal because at the moment it's -5 degrees here, so it's pretty chilly, but it's really warm inside, and so what can you do? Lots of my clothes are kind of warm toned as well, so it goes with my clothes and my outfits. And I'm just taking that a little bit down my eyelash line. Okay, that is the first eye blended out. I'm going to do the same on the other eye off camera and I'll be right back. Okay, so I've built up the crease colour on both of my eyes, and that is our kind of crease transition done. As you can see, I've brought that all the way over my lid and down underneath my eyes somewhat. Some people tell me that because I'm quite pale, I can't wear colours like this because it makes me look ill to some respect. I agree, but I think that once you bring like a really vibrant colour, like a red or something, into the look and then put a pop of shimmer on, I think it looks fine. So that's what we're going to do today. Lots of my brushes are being cleaned and drying at the moment, so I am just using the same brush, but I think that shows the versatility of brushes like this, which are kind of fluffy. It's really easy to pick product up, they're really soft. This one was £1 from Primark. And I really recommend it if anybody's looking for an affordable brush. Anyway, we're going to pop into this bright pink shade right here, and I'm going to take that into the outer corner and then kind of across my lid. As you can see, that's really starting to emulate the fire that I was talking about earlier. Yesterday I did pop into the bright orange colour, but I actually found that I didn't really need that because of the way the brown mixed with the yellow, you can see it's kind of orangey anyway. Okay, that's that eye done. I'm going to do the other eye now. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to take kind of a clear blending brush like this, and I'm just going to buff the corners. One thing I feel that I kind of want from this palette that it doesn't like give is kind of not another transition shade, because obviously this is bright and I don't kind of begrudge the palette not having this, but kind of a pale highlighty shade that just you can kind of blend out your edges and pop under your brow bone. But obviously that isn't the purpose of this palette, to kind of be like that, so I'm not begrudging that at all. But I am going to pop into my Heat palette and just take Ounce and just use that as kind of a highlighty shade underneath my brow bone. I just think it kind of finishes off the edges quite nicely, and there you can see. And the same on the other eye. Okay, now I'm taking a flat packer brush from Start Maker. This is damp so that I can kind of foil the shadows on, and I'm going to take my brush and go into this colour right here. This is my second favourite colour in the palette, the first favourite being this green shade that we used in the first look. This one is kind of a rosy pink gold duochrome and it's really lovely all over the lid, so I'm just going to take my brush in there. It picks up like this, it's beautiful, and then I'm going to take my mirror and I'm just going to pack that onto my lid, and you can kind of see the shine straight away and it's absolutely lovely. Taking a bit more and just making sure that I kind of carve out my lid with this. And that is our lid colour. It kind of goes really well with the look, I think, so I'm going to take that onto the other eye as well. Okay, so that is our lid colour. I think that's turned out really nice. It's a really simple and easy look to copy. That's using the Juvia's Zulu palette. I'm going to pop some mascara on and finish the rest of my face, and I'll be right back. Okay, so this is the finished look using the Zulu palette by Juvia's Place. It's turned out really nice, really fiery, as promised. I've really been enjoying experimenting a bit more with colour. If you'd like to see some more looks using this palette, there are very many possibilities, and I'd really like to try some kind of orange and blue looks, use complementary colours, which would be really fun. Please leave a comment down below. Hit like if you've enjoyed this video. It's been lovely making it. And yeah, subscribe to my channel. There'll be lots of videos coming out, and have a lovely day.